So Grazia Daily is here with Tali Lennox before the Mango show that's happening tonight in Paris. Are you excited?
Yeah, it should be really nice.
Are you going to be walking in it?
No, I won't be, which is actually going to be quite fun, being a different perspective, knowing all the stresses and craziness that happens backstage in preparation for a show. So. Yeah.
Have you got any crazy backstage stories of things that have happened?
There are a few. Julia McDonald was nuts. 45 minutes, not too late, because the girls coming from Giles, like, they had to change, like, 17 girls, bleached their eyebrows, changed their hair in space of, like, 20 minutes, and then they left my shoes at a different place. Oh. So I had to do a shoe change. What you can't see when you see the video is that I literally did not make it on. I had to get, like, but I was literally, like, screaming, couldn't get these boots on, had to run. Each backstage is kind of nuts. I've never been to a calm backstage room, but it's got the, like, amazing energy to it. Yeah. Like Marc Jacobs this season was just like, oh, crazy. It was like so, just, yeah, kind of bizarre but amazing. Yeah.
And talking about bleached eyebrows, has anyone ever asked to do something on you?
Yeah, like, mine had just grown back. They're not really.
Oh, did they bleach?
I got them bleached for Topshop and then Julia McDonald, and then I kept them on stupidly, I don't know why, and then. I was getting them dyed back finally at a casting to make one, so I was like, oh, do you say? She was like, oh, I can do it back in Milan during the shows, and then I had to go to Prada while the dye was still on, so take them off in the car.
So
I've had salt and pepper brows for a while, but I think they covered them
off. Coming back to normal. Were you a convert? Did you like having bleached brows?
I really liked it, but it was kind of thing, like, you think great at the time, and then you look back and you're like, wow, no, I looked like a baby. No, I go in and look like a baby, I look really just scary and slightly sickly.
Because
I thought, because I was like, oh yeah, like, go to Milan, it's quite a strong look for the castings, and then I get there, like, they just see, like, you didn't tie it, you had your bleached eyebrows, like, they don't like that so much in Italy, you might want to tie them back. But yeah, they're just coming back now. It's going for a bit of a thicker brow look.
Yeah, it's nice. Thank you. So speaking of Mango, how did it come about that you're modelling for them?
They just got in touch with my agency. So pretty simple and nice, but no, it's really nice to build a whole new relationship with a new brand and a brand that's, you know, it's nice to do a high street brand as well that's really accessible to people that I've obviously known about for a while, and yeah, it's really nice.
And to follow the likes of Penelope Cruz and Scarlett.
Yeah, it's kind of nuts. Yeah. Yeah, it was a privilege, just like flattering, but I'm just lucky to be here.
And Penelope Cruz designed a line for Mango. Would you ever consider doing something like that?
Yeah, I'd be really up for it. I mean, yeah, definitely.
What would we expect from
something quite vintage inspired, something that takes reference from different eras, maybe the 70s or maybe like something like the 20s, or go that far. Bit quirky, feminine, lots of prints, lots of rich colours, good cuts.
Is that how you'd describe your own personal style?
Yeah, well, kind of. I like to be really eclectic and kind of, yeah, add a bit of quirk and take, again, references from different kinds of eras.
And so who would you say is your style icon?
I don't have a style icon, really. I don't really have one person I follow. I just like different. I mean, I think style icon's anyone who inspires you in the way they dress, so it could be kind of a stranger in the street or someone or a friend you have. So anyone, I think. But I just like, yeah, I like vintage clothes. I like different, like, times in history and kind of a whole look to it and a whole atmosphere that goes with it.
Yeah.
So, like, I really love, like, retro 70s. Then I also love, like, really 1920s Hollywood glamour as well.
Do you ever steal anything from your mum's wardrobe?
Yeah, all the time. all the time. She doesn't mind. Loads of, she has really good jewellery because I'm not really good at buying jewellery. Hats, loads of hats.
Where's this ring from?
This is Mango, actually, but she has really good. I was wearing one of her rings today, but she's got really good rings as well. But this is a really, really nice Mango one. I like it a lot.
Yeah,
because again, like, what's great about this and this is it looks kind of vintagey a little bit. It looks kind of like it could be vintage or older. But that's what I like. I mean, I get vintage and secondhand, but both. But it has kind of a nostalgia to it, which is what I like.
And does your mum ever steal anything from your wardrobe?
No. Can't imagine that happening. I mean, she kind of gives me all the clothes that she doesn't really wear, and she kind of enjoys that, but she always, I mean, she just picks out things she finds are nice and sometimes won't wear them. Never wears, like, designer clothes or anything. But,
so if there was anyone's wardrobe, like, at the moment, is there anyone who you look at and think, oh, I'd love to look like them, or, like, a model who inspires you?
I'm going to know exactly straight after, I think. You know, I'm really not sure. I don't really follow someone's fashion that religiously, to be honest. I think Dita Von Teese is crazy cool style.
Yeah.
She just always stays her one thing. I love that kind of again, like 50s as well.
Yeah.
She kind of really flatters her figure really well and accentuates this look that she has with work so well.
Yeah.
And I really like how she puts effort into what she wears all the time and like does it up to the nine kind of things. When I go out, I really like to like do the whole thing and do makeup and put things together. Apart from that, I'm sure I'll probably know straight after. I've already known how you think, oh my god, yeah, they're amazing. Forgot about that, but
But speaking of your style, I don't know if you've seen in Grazia, we do fashion jewellery. And so we'd love to do a fashion jewellery for you on yourself.
Ooh,
so look, I've brought some lovely pictures. If you can hold them up to the camera. And just tell us about each, just three outfits, each one. If you can just tell us why you picked the outfit, where you were. There's a little
story. This was over a year ago. This was kind of... I mean, I would never wear that now, but that's the thing. But I kind of like that because it's a bit bohemian, and I have different... I got those from the hippie market in Ibiza.
Oh, cool.
The necklaces I got from the hippie market as well. Kind of like, this is a bit more... I wouldn't wear this now because it's a bit more rough around the edges.
It's like a good festival.
Yeah, exactly. But I mean, I like wearing these kind of clothes in the summer if I'm at a festival, apart from that. Not when I'm out there.
Do you like going to little festivals?
I've been to a festival at Coachella. But there everyone really dresses up. Coachella's great. Like, it's bizarre. Like, it's so different from English festivals. Like, it's so much more luxurious.
Yeah.
Like, so much. The LA crowd is not as leery as English crowd. I mean, in good ways and bad ways. But they had parties at like Elvis Presley's house. And, like, it was insane. Yeah, but really great. Really the cool. Bands are great. And I went to my favourite festival, Secret Garden Party, which I planned to probably go to. I really want to do a festival diary there, maybe, I'm thinking. Yeah. But because the people, the clothes they wear there, it's like everyone gets dressed up, everything looks incredible, everyone's just nice to each other.
Yeah.
So the first festival I went to was Reading, which is like hell on earth, and everyone's horrible, and everyone wants to kill each other. It wasn't my idea of fun.
Not so glamorous.
This is a really great Dolce & Gabbana dress. I really like the, like, it's kind of it's really feminine.
That's kind of Dieter Von Teese.
Exactly. I like kind of gothic-y style as well, kind of almost creepy style. With really pale skin. A lot more feminine.
And the red lipstick looks great.
Yeah.
Are you more of a lipstick kind of girl, or would you go for the
eyes? I like lips. I like either one. I kind of like experimenting with makeup as well.
Mix it up.
This was a long time ago.
Awesome.
That was like, god, that was 3 years ago now.
Was that one of the first fashion shows you've been to?
Yeah, that was before I started modelling. I kind of looked different as well.
And then did you get...
don't know about that hair, to be honest, but this is Dolce & Gabbana as well, and I wear a lot of their stuff, and they have just do really great dresses. That I think their aesthetic is so great. It's really powerful, feminine.
Yeah.
It's nostalgic as well.
Yeah.
Like, it's really kind of the 1950s. It's, you know, it has the same kind of... Yeah, I just think you feel great in my clothes, basically. Really great, rich colours. I think that dress is great as well because it has an extra quirk to it. It's a bit different, but it's not too wacky.
Yeah.
And it has... It's nice and short. I love anything that's really short.
Yeah.
And wedges, which I'm obsessed with. Like, they're my favourite kind of heel, is wedges.
Perfect. Well, that's good. You've passed with flying colours. Well
done.
Thank you. Well, yes, that's it. Thank you very much for speaking to us, and
thanks
we'll see you tonight.
Bye. Thanks. Bye.